Personal log. Mission Specialist Kate Ward. Sentient Contact Assessment and Response Team. We always wondered if we're alone in the universe. We observed and explored, but found nothing. Until now.
Call Mission Control to Hermes. Status check.
All systems nominal. We're working on a solution for our scan power requirement. We'll update soon.
Roger that, Hermes. Keep us posted.
Kate, we have an issue.
Problem with the scan?
We've underestimated the power requirements necessary to penetrate the Metahedron's hull. Mike has an idea, but he could use a hand. He's in the lab and he'll give you the details.
On my way. The day when Tam and I graduated and decided to join the space program. Never thought it would lead to alien objects in space. Tam was lucky that Robinson interrupted us. I was on the verge of victory.
It has been 6 months since the alien object known as the Metahedron suddenly appeared above Earth's atmosphere. The Hermes mission is currently making preparations to engage with it and attempt contact. Earlier this morning,
hey, Kate. I think I figured out a way to give us the power we need for the scan. I've attached the scanners directly to the engines.
Wow. Directly? Brave.
I think it'll work, but we need to find a way to kickstart the process with around 500,000 volts.
Do we still have those SLD-26 welders in the equipment room?
Yeah, I think we have one or two, but why do you... Oh.
You want to modify it to discharge high-voltage electricity. And you call me brave.
Oh, boy.
Now I need to craft a rail module at the mobile printing unit. There. It should be strong enough to direct and focus the electrical current. And now to fit all this together. I see Mr. Jefferson is in the lab today.
Yeah, I never leave my home planet without him.
Only missing a power source. I have to adjust the frequency of the Tesla coil first. There. Now just to calibrate the output voltage.
That looks like a space blaster.
Just a tool. Nothing else. It's a vectorized energy rail accelerator, discharging electrical...
Vera! Let's call it Vera for short.
You sure like to name things. Vera it is. Mike, I'm in front of the reactor. What's the best way to power it with extra energy?
See the three positronic nodes surrounding the core? A jolt to each one would be sufficient. Yes! Keep it up! Almost there. We need a little more energy for the reaction. Huh. Let's try a direct shot to the core. Straight to the heart.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous at all.
It's working. I'm feeding the excess power directly to the scanner.
I haven't seen you shoot like this since the college rifle championship.
Yeah, I also remember you taking first place from me.
And don't you forget it.
Good job. Dr. Ward, Dr. Yoshida, get to the bridge, please. Time to see what's inside our alien guest.
I should return Vera to the equipment room. She served her purpose.
Telemetry check.
Telemetry check. We're go.
How are we doing with that sensor array, Mike?
We're ready, Commander.
You have the honors, Dr. Ward. Take your place when ready and start the scan.
Excess energy seems to have done the trick. The array is locked on the metahedron and operating at almost 200% of its standard efficiency. Say the word, Commander.
Just a moment, Dr. Ward. Team, can I have your attention, please? Since the dawn of humankind, our species has gazed toward the skies and wondered whether we were truly alone. Well, 6 months ago, we got our answer. And with it came new questions. What is this object in front of us? Where did it come from? Who sent it? And why? While the governments, leaders, thinkers, and common people discussed the meaning of this event, we were training. We were preparing. The SCAR team. Now, the whole world is relying on us. We're dreamers and skeptics. We're explorers and pioneers. With hearts and minds. With courage and resolution. With trust and fellowship. With science. We're going to give the world their answers. And in this historic moment at the conjunction of hopes and fears, there's no people I'd rather face the unknown with. Dr. Ward, you have the honors. Let's do this.
Yes, Commander. Scared?
Of course I am.
I thought you Army pilots were trained not to be.
We're trained to control it. The fear keeps us sharp. How are you holding up, Doctor?
Oh, I'm 100% sharp, all right.
So, do you think it's a weapon?
Well, a weapon is a very human concept. Perhaps what we perceive as a weapon is just a tool. Wait, the scan. The metahedron's energy levels are rising rapidly. Okay, what happened?
Power supply failing.
Sensors offline.
I'm switching to backup generators. I'll try to reroute.
Look. The metahedron, it's creating some sort of a gravity well.
The Hermes is being pulled towards it.
Hang on, everyone. Dr. Ward. Kate!
Commander Robinson? Tam? Mike? Anyone? Where are you? What is this place? What's happening?
Sayatana.
Who was that? Where am I? How is this possible? What planet is this? Did the Metahedron bring us here? Some sort of alien structure. Emergency signal. It must be someone from the team. I have to get to them. The debris, it's from the Hermes. It must have splintered off when the ship entered the atmosphere. A Scarfield backpack. Empty, but still useful. This electric cutter can cut through even the toughest materials. I'd better take it with me. Log entry. A joint-legged invertebrate life form, similar to Arachnida. Fast movement, small frame. Seems to move in groups. They're dead. Must be a gate of some sorts. There's no obvious locking mechanism. Log entry. The gate has an internal conduction system. The three points on the rim seem sensitive. A targeted blast of electricity could cause a reaction. Log entry. This plant doesn't have any chloroplasts, which means it can't conduct photosynthesis. Strange.
Just a bit. We don't want to fry the coil. There. Awesome. We did it, Kate.
I remember this. Mike and I were finishing our electrical experiment just after lunch. Vera, it's still intact. Feels like I'm moving through entrails. Log entry. I found a strange alien cube. It's emitting neural waves. This means it has the potential to send information directly to the brain. Thank you. log entry? Large joint-legged organism. The chemicals in its abdomen can create an explosion when heated to a certain temperature. Another one of these pillars. These cables, they're from the Hermes. Some kind of flesh-like webbing. I have to break through it. Log entry. This is a bio-vessel for an indigenous creature. The shell seems highly combustible. It contains an organism that is almost fully formed. I better not touch it. Log entry. Strong organic tissue, but the blisters appear to be filled with diethyl ether, most likely flammable. This equipment, it's from the Hermes, but we were there just an hour ago. The whole place is covered with some kind of organic residue.
Commander Richard Robinson, log entry. Ever since I left the Hermes, it's been getting worse. The growth. I have to get it off. I've salvaged some electrical components. I might be able to craft an incendiary device with the MPU. Burn the growth! The body must be cleansed!
Ever since he left the Hermes? But we were just there. He sounds different. Enraged. Print a custom emitter with the MPU, connect it with the thermic module, and attach it all to the welder's frame. This might burn straight through that flesh-like webbing. And I'm taking the MPU. You again.
Mama Tuva, how far would you go in the search for answers?
Thank you.
incredible. What could the purpose of such a colossal structure be? Energy relocation?
How far would you go?
Robinson's backpack. He was here. I should look around and try to reconstruct his move. The whole backpack is covered in organic residue. Robinson must have lost balance and grabbed this rock. Seemed like he had trouble walking. Carnivorous worm-like organisms secreting acidic saliva. It would melt my suit and my flesh in moments. Robinson's boot. Apparently, he was heading towards the water. He had issues walking, but pushed himself into the worm-infested water. The worms converged on him. They seemed to fuse with his body. What happened to you, Richard? His signal is on the other side. Somehow he got through the worms. I won't last a moment, but I must find a way across. Log entry. Seems like this part of the structure is the command panel, but I'm not getting any energy readings from it. It must be deactivated. I can see the energy points on the gate from this side. Oh my God! aggressiveness of these creatures goes beyond typical territorial behavior. Is something causing such hostility? Log entry. I'm detecting strong electrical energy inside the sack. If the protective membrane is hit with an electric charge, it will explode.
I found another riot. Field outpost Tetra. Marsh biome. Report. Mutations are at stage 3. Specimens are enveloping themselves in mineral material, creating a... stone-like outer shell. Their genetic structure is stable. Alpha of the pack is growing exponentially, which is promising. Genetic code fragment harvested.
A recording of some sort. It sounds like a report from some kind of experiment. Was that thing? These creatures, it looks like their secretion is freezing the water. Log entry. The creature's carapace is underdeveloped. If I find a mature specimen, I might be able to utilize their freezing secretion. I better stick to the frozen surface if I don't want to be eaten alive. This one is huge. It's producing large quantities of that freezing secretion. The appendages are dripping with the fluid that's freezing the water. There's the brain, and the neural pathopseudocerebrum seems to be generating an electrical charge. This gland is secreting the cryogenic fluid that's freezing the water. The cocktail of digestive acids is dissolving local plant life into homogeneous matter. The process seems to be aided by and this neural pathway is conducting large amounts of bioelectricity. The creature is mixing bioelectricity with whatever it digests to generate an enzyme, and the enzyme is used to create a cryogenic fluid in the cranial gland. So if I take a sample, I might be able to replicate the process. I might be able to use this to craft some kind of cryogenic device with the MPU. It could help me to get through the worms. Let's see if this device works. It's working! This way should take me back to the monolith. A console of some sort. Two parts are missing. Log entry. The bulbous growths on the creature's back act as storage for enormous quantities of digestive enzymes. Rupturing them will deal massive damage and incapacitate the creature.
Genetic mutation is affecting the creature's aggression levels. Hostility of stage 3 mutations increased by several magnitudes. I am continuing observation.
An alien artifact could be useful. One of the drones.
Observer.
Observer? What are they observing? Interesting. This device could be a part of a larger whole. Nothing's happening. I should scan the inside of the console and try to figure it out. There appears to be three power sources. Each power source is connected to the top of the console. These symbols on the power sources seem familiar.
Thank you.
Those pyramids have the same symbols as the power sources. Perhaps if I could position them correctly? Technology indistinguishable from magic. The storm. Same as before. I must push on.
He destroyed us. We never suspected what was to come. The custodian.
The custodian?
Monsters, they are letting me pass. It's my body. The growth. I have to cleanse it.
Thank you.
growth! Burn! Burn at you! Ah! Burn it!
What is wrong with Richard? Commander Robinson?
Kate, I've been waiting so long, but the fear...
Richard.
The fear kept me sharp. Burn, Nebra! The body!
Now's my chance.
Richard, I'm so sorry. I had no choice.
What happened to you, Richard? Tam, Mike, I hope you're alive. I need to reach the crash site.